The Awakening of the Baobhan Sith. The small town of Glenlyn, nestled between the hills, bore the weight of age in its stone rooftops and cobbled streets. Locals often found solace in stories, the older the better. Yet, among all tales, there was one that sent shivers through their spines just as twilight began to wrap the world in its velvet embrace. The tale of the Baobhan Sith, a vampiric fairy from Scottish folklore who was said to lure men into the woods, never to return. For 16-year-old Nate, such stories were mere whispers meant to scare children. He had grown up hearing his grandmother weave magnificent tales of mythical creatures hidden in the crevices of the forest, but that year's Halloween felt different. With the unwavering grip of curiosity entwining his thoughts, his friends dared him to venture into the Hazelwood, a dense expanse bordering the town said to be haunted by the Baobhan Sith. "Why don't you just ask your grandma to give you a few more horror stories?" his friend Lisa teased, her voice lined with mockery as they stood at the edge of the forest, gnarled trees clawing at the evening sky. Nate's stomach twisted with unease, but he hid it behind a facade of bravado. "You're all chicken. I bet I will find some proof of her existence tonight," he shot back, masking his nervousness. As dusk sank lower, casting eerie shadows across the forest floor, Nate stepped into the dense thicket, the chill of the night taking root in his bones. He ventured deeper, the light of his flashlight piercing through curving branches and thick underbrush. As the last flickers of the sun's light succumbed to darkness, the air thickened, crawling with an uncanny silence. Suddenly, he heard a soft hum, delicate yet haunting. He paused, straining to make sense of the melody woven into the woodsy sounds, and he stepped toward it, lost in a reverie of curiosity. That was when he saw her, a figure standing amidst the trees, pale skin shimmering under the light of the moon, with long dark hair cascading like shadows. She was beautiful and unsettling all at once. "Who are you?" Nate whispered, unable to turn back. "I am the one who has waited for a kindred spirit," she replied, her voice melodic as it danced on the wind, invading his mind and wrapping around his heart. "Step closer, handsome boy. Don't you want to see the secrets of the night?" The words beckoned to him like intoxicating nectar, and Nate's heart raced. He noticed her elegant dress, a tattered gown woven from the night sky, where stars twinkled in and out of existence. Desire pulled him forward, every step ensnaring him deeper into her world. The legend spoke about a bewitching beauty with a thirst for blood, yet, in that moment, all he felt was a longing so deep it threatened to consume him whole. Without realizing, he was near enough to feel her breath against his skin, cool and sweet, laced with the aroma of spring blooms and ancient forest floor. "You're so brave, wandering out here alone," she purred, revealing sharp, glistening fangs that caught the moonlight. A chill shot down Nate's spine. The stories came rushing back, a flood of forgotten warnings about the Baobhan Sith and her penchant for entrapping young men. Panic surged through him. "I think I should go," he stammered, trying to back away. "Go? But the night has just begun," she cooed, her eyes gleaming with a predatory hunger. "Your friends will never find you, you know. They don't care for this forest, or for you." Quote, before he could speak, she lunged, her hand reaching for him. Instinct took over, and he turned on his heel, sprinting into the depths of the Hazelwood, branches clawing at his skin like skeletal fingers trying to drag him back. He could hear the flutter of her dress behind him, a ghostly whispering against the breeze with every step he took. Nate glanced back, his heart pounding in time with the fading echo of her laughter, a melodic chime that sent cold perspiration running down his spine. The woods closed in around him, shadows morphing into twisted forms, making him question the reality of what he was experiencing. The legends were real, the creature was real, and time was no longer a luxury he could afford. He was terrified, but with each glance back, her figure grew closer, her seductive aura shifting into something monstrous. Raw survival instinct kicked in, dopamine flooding his system as he ran faster than he ever had, driven by the tales of old. He stumbled back to the town's outskirts, breathless and shaking, bursting through the threshold between the familiar and the unknown. "That was foolish," Lisa exclaimed, worry etched across her freckled face as she saw his pallor. "What happened to you?" "They were right," he gasped, glancing back toward the ominous trees, trembling at the thought of the near collision with an indescribable darkness. "I saw her, the Baobhan Sith. She's real. We have to warn everyone." But something in the air had shifted. The night was now alive with an otherworldly energy, and somehow, Nate knew he'd only escaped for now. As the shadows lengthened, he felt a shiver creeping down his spine, the sensation of being watched. The strange lullaby echoed faintly through the night, just beyond the threshold of the woods, coaxing him back, promising unfathomable secrets and blissful oblivion. And deep within the dark embrace of the forest, the Baobhan Sith waited, her laughter lingering like a sweet poison, eager for the next unsuspecting soul to wander too close to the edge of her domain.